Hi Libra, welcome to Loveful Tarot. My name is David and today we're going to be doing your general love reading for the month of November 2022. This is going to be for any Libra looking for any guidance and messages in their daily love lives. Remember Libra, this is going to be for Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus in your charts here with Libra. And of course, we don't take ourselves too seriously. Always a chill vibe here with me, okay? So let's begin with your reading, Libra. I'm going to do one card here from the Romance Angel Oracle deck. Then we're going to do a 9-card spread, bottom of the deck energy, plus clarifiers and extra messages later as well, okay? So universe, let's find out what we need to know for Libra, please. Let's get a clear message here. What is coming up here for Libra? For the collective, what is going up in their love life right now? So let's figure out. Okay, so we have flirt. That will be your energy. Extend your lighthearted energy to others. Okay, you will be flirting, you will be in this energy. That is what is going on for you right now, Libra. Extending lighthearted energy to others. So, not too serious, but lighthearted energy, you know, this is going to be part of your month this month, okay, Libra? So let's find out what we need to know. I'm going to draw a 9-card spread. We'll start with your past, present, and future energies, Libra. Universe, please give me a clear message here for Libra, please. For November 2022, what does Libra need to know? Okay. So let's begin with your reading. Your first card out, we have, it's the 9 of Swords. Past energies. Next, we have the 5 of Cups. And lastly, we have the 8 of Pentacles in reverse. So I'm getting here for a lot of you. Swords is very much a painful energy, okay? There's some sort of stress here that you've been going through in the past. This is like anxious energy, nervousness, fears, things that keep you awake in your sleep here, things that you've been thinking about way too much, putting too much energy into negativity as well for some of you. It is the worrying card here, okay? If you can see. So I'm getting here that's something that you've had to deal with here in the past. Some of you may still be dealing with it. 5 of Cups is sadness. 5 of Cups is heartbreak. 5 of Cups is feeling sorry for yourself. There's a withdrawn energy here from a lot of you Libras, okay? And this is because of a situation or how you view things, how you think about things, and what's driving you here with the 9 of Swords. It's causing you a lot of this sadness here, regret. 8 of Pentacles in reverse is about working towards something, working hard towards a goal here. And so you almost feel lost in a way. Or you don't know where to start, what to work on, where to put your efforts, your energy. Okay? So that's your past energy. Let's find out more about your present energy for you. And we'll draw clarifiers, of course. Next we have is the 9 of Wands. Your next card for you, Libra, we have the 7 of Cups. Choices. And lastly, we have the Page of Pentacles. So 9 of Wands, 7 of Cups, Page of Pentacles. Right now in your present energy, some of you are still a little bit guarded. The 9 of Wands is a guarded energy, keeping to oneself, keeping things around us sheltered here, being safe, keeping yourself safe, I'm getting. 7 of Cups. Multiple offers, multiple choices, multiple decisions. That's what you're faced with. Could be people that you're dealing with, dating, connecting with, chatting, relationships. All the opportunities are coming toward you now. So you're seeing things starting to pop up. Whatever, whether it be people or something to do with your love life here, there will be opportunities for you coming up. Page of Pentacles could be a love offer, could be a message coming in for you. someone may be flirting with you in this energy. Could be Earth energy, Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn for you, Libra, okay? It's a very innocent energy. So is your message about flirt, okay? Extend your lighthearted energy to others. Remember that. That will be your energy for the month. It's very clear. Okay, let's take a look at your future energies for you. We have here the Knight of Swords. Next card. Oh, we have the Death in reverse. Major changes. And then we have the Three of Wands. Waiting for something. So your future energy can start off here with the Knight of Wands. Could be a person. Let's talk about that. So it could be air individual. This could be represented by yourself as well. If not, the air individual will be another Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius. Getting a sense here that a lot of you are moving towards something, connecting, communicating. The Knight of Swords is a very quick and thrustful energy here, okay? He's one of the faster knights. Comes in with haste into a situation. The Death card in reverse, letting go of something. You're letting go of something, Libra. And this is something that you've been holding on to for a while, that you have problems letting go of or changing. Some of you, I'm getting here that like the change is abrupt and you weren't expecting it to happen. So it was like, bam, oh, I didn't realize, wow, like I'm like totally taken off guard here. I don't know what I'm doing or whatever. That energy of the unknown here is a little bit fear. You are fearful of it. It comes a bit unexpectedly. But it's something that's going to be happening regardless at some point. If it hasn't happened yet for some of you Libras, this will be happening sometime in your future. It doesn't have to be in the next month, this month, but this is coming up in your future energies. And the Death card is you're leading up to a major change for yourself, okay? Three of Wands, patiently waiting on a situation, waiting on something. I'm not sure what that is. But we'll get some more clarifiers here for you, okay? So I'm going to find out what we need to know here. Let's find out more about this sadness. Let's find out about the Five of Cups, okay? So Libra, let's get a clear message for the Five of Cups. What is the Five of Cups about? Tell me more. We have the Two of Wands in reverse. We have the Hanged Man and we have the Page of Swords in reverse. Okay. Clarifying the Five of Cups. What is the sadness about? It's about missed opportunity here. Someone made a choice here. Wasn't a negative outcome came out of that. The Hanged Man waiting. You're sad. But the energy of you is waiting on something, waiting on reacting to something, but not reacting. Just sitting on the sidelines with the Hanged Man, okay? Page of Swords could be another air individual, could be about you as well. But I'm getting here, it's like there's no communication happening in your past. With the Page of Swords, it's about communicating, it's about news, it's about something. Getting here that there's, with the Hanged Man, it's definitely not communicating, holding off, because you can't make a decision right now, and you're holding on to sadness. Let's find out about the Eight of Pentacles for you. Universe, tell me more about the Eight of Pentacles. Tell me more about the Eight of Pentacles, please. In reverse, oops. Tell me more, please. Okay, so we have the Six of Pentacles in reverse. We have the Six of Wands, and we have the Five of Cups, but in reverse now. Yeah, things are slowly changing for you. The sadness, you're slowly coming out of that. And you may not be putting work into a situation or a relationship or a person from your past here. but you've been keeping this energy to yourself. You don't want to share it for a lot of you. And that's given you this new vigor and energy, okay? Like this recharge that you needed by not connecting. With the Five of Cups in reverse, that sadness is coming out. We see the Five of Cups here just previously. Now you're in the reverse. You are slowly coming out of that sadness because of some new energy here, okay? Could be that new individual coming through to you, whatever lighthearted energies are coming. But let's find out more about the Nine of Wands. What about this defensive energy for you here, Libra? What is going on? Tell me more about the Nine of Wands, please. Tell me more. The Nine of Wands. We have the Four of Cups. Queen of Cups in reverse. The Judgment card in reverse. Could be a water sign you're dealing with. Okay. You are nervous about something, guarded, because you're afraid to love again. Four of Cups, afraid of connections, afraid of commitment here. Queen of Cups, because emotionally you are affected somehow. You could be feeling depressed or unstable. Emotions are something that you have issues really being able to either submit to completely, or you have an issue with feeling the full range here, okay? Or it could be some negative emotions here that aren't really what you like to showcase about yourself. The Judgment card, being stuck in the past about something, not having that awakening, having some sort of cloudy judgment on a situation, not seeing things, not learning from your lessons, from your past mistakes. Yeah. So those are what's in your thought and the energies that's coming in right now for you. Let's find out about these Seven of Cups, okay? Universe, tell me more about the Seven of Cups, please. What do we need to know for Libra? We have the Eight of Swords. We have the Seven of Pentacles in reverse and the Four of Swords. Okay. I'm getting something still makes you nervous. Seven of Pentacles. Like, you're not putting as much effort into the situation here, and you're getting lots of offers here, but it's making you nervous because you have trust issues here. Four of Swords, some of you may lay low for a while. Some of you may choose to lay off certain things for a while. Four of Swords, resting period. Time of reflection here. Or it could be that you put in work into a certain situation or a certain person or energy here. And a lot of you find a lot of peace with this person. And so whatever selections you may have, they may be singled out into one person right now. Okay. So let's find out about the Page of Pentacles. Tell me more about the Page of Pentacles, please. So Page of Pentacles, King of Swords in reverse, Knight of Cups in reverse, Ace of Cups in reverse. Okay. There may be other people here in your life here. King of Swords could be an air sign, could be your energy as well. Knight of Cups, dismissed offer of love, Ace of Cups, no new beginning here. Page of Pentacles. There could be some sort of communication issue here. Miscommunication about something. Knight of Cups about a love offer. Ace of Cups about a new beginning. Either being stalled or not happening, or someone being fearful here. But there is some sort of offer that will be coming through, or some sort of news or something. Communication. Okay. Let's find out in the future energies about the Knight of Swords. What is going on for Libra with the Knight of Swords, please? Tell me about the Knight of Swords. Okay. What is this Knight of Swords about? Two of Pentacles. Weighing decision here. Three of Wands in reverse. Being impatient about waiting about something. The High Priestess not realizing something that's in front of you. Not trusting your gut. You will be coming forth with an energy here towards a person. It's you've been weighing on a decision here, juggling back and forth about something. Being impatient about a situation or moving through with something. High Priestess not listening to your gut. High Priestess in reverse, not listening to something about that you know deep down in your gut, okay? Excuse me. Let's find out about the Death card in reverse. Tell me about the Death card. What about this transition that's happening for you in the near future? What else do you need to know here for Libra, please? Tell me more about the Death card in reverse, please. Knight of Swords in reverse again. But this is in reverse, though. Strength card, the Hierophant. Strength card, Leo energy, Hierophant. Taurus energy you could be dealing with, okay? It doesn't have to be. Death card, Scorpio energy as well. Nine of Swords. This transition is going to happen slowly for some of you. It could be because of a deception or some sort of bad news coming in here. The Strength card. This trumps the Knight of Swords for me. I feel like you have all what you need to accomplish a certain goal or connection here. You believe in love. You have the strength and the courage to make it happen. The Hierophant. There is trust and connectivity here with an individual that goes beyond, the physical realm. Could be spiritual connection, soulmate energy here. The Hierophant talks about traditions and also about connecting on a more unique kind of way here. Sometimes I read the Hierophant as not following traditional values. But this is, to me, some sort of new union, new connection, because you made it happen. Knight of Swords. There will be a transition here because of some information coming into you. And there will be a big upset. Unexpected energy, like I said. It's going to happen fast, but you'll be able to deal with it. Let's find out about the Three of Wands, please. Universe, tell me about the Three of Wands. Tell me about the Three of Wands, please. What else are you waiting for here? King of Pentacles in reverse. The Star card, Aquarius energy. Ace of Swords in reverse. Okay. I'm getting here. King of Pentacles. You could be working on career, could be working on work, you could be working on money, valuable things, material things. You may be distracted with that. The Star card is about wishes and dreams coming true. And for you, these things are still going to be happening for you. You'll realize certain dreams and truths within yourself that will renew your energy, be very thoughtful, be very awakening for you. Ace of Swords could be a pause or withholding information here. You may have to lie about something. You may have to change information. You may have to communicate differently. You may have to make a decision that you won't be able to, but that's tied to your new path, tied to your new star energy, your star path, your goals, your dreams. You may want to continue with the King of Pentacles energy. King of Pentacles could represent Earth as well. This King of Pentacles also means your work ethic, your material life, what you do. You may be waiting on that. Whatever it is, you have your dreams and goals set. And some of you may need time before you have your start. But it's something that you definitely feel confident about, okay? All right. So I am getting flirty vibes here. but I'm also getting some cautionary energy for you as well. Some of you may be waiting on something, and there is a major transition coming through, okay? So some of you with that flirt energy, you may be transitioning and being more open with yourself and communicating better, okay? This is for some. For others, this flirtatious energy leads on to something else. So let's find out some extra messages for you. I'm going to start with the Hidden Truth deck here. Universe, let's find out a Hidden Truth here for Libra, please, for the month of November. There's two, so we'll take them both. Okay. I have, just being near you is intoxicating. This is how you feel about an individual here. I feel you leaving me behind. So this could be coming from two separate energies here. I would take it however it resonates. I feel you leaving me behind. Someone may be moving forward too fast, but the attraction is there. All right, let's find out about the messages of love. We're going to get a few here as well. Universe, let's get a couple cards here for Libra, please. What else for Libra? Give me more. Let's take a couple more. Okay. One more. One more for Libra, please. Oh, that's too many, but we'll take that one. Okay. So, Libra, we have first integrity. Does this situation align with your values and morals? Something to think about here. There's that connection, flirtatious energy. Are you keeping your integrity? Are you listening to your gut, the High Priestess? Are you making the right choices? Weighing your options, Two of Pentacles. Awakening. Someone is undergoing a spiritual transformation. That is you. Could be someone you're dealing with, but most likely you. Support, lean on your inner circle during this time. So some of you may need family, friends, whatever that is, that's what you work on. That's what you need to focus your energies on if you feel you need help with anything. But again, very much a lighthearted energy. I wouldn't say this death card is, you know, a complete overhaul, but it's definitely a big step in towards love for you and connections. So take it as it resonates, Libra. I hope you guys enjoy the reading. Remember, if this doesn't resonate with you, I'll have other videos coming up for you soon. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I really appreciate it. I really do appreciate also you watching till the end. Thanks for joining me. Bye again.